One latest creation. 10-inch flywheel, flame licker engine.
Hey guys, Joe and Rocket TV One here. And so this is my newest little creation. It is a flame licker engine. And I have like about an hour and 20 minutes of the build video of this. It's a lot longer than that. But that's what I've condensed down to. It's not about a blueprint because this comes out of my head. So this print has nothing to do with it. That's a different job. This was made out of all kinds of scrap parts. And so I guess part of this video here is asking my subscribers and whoever finds this, do you want to see the whole hour and a half, hour and 10 minutes, whatever it turns into, in one chunk video so you could just watch it at your leisure? Or do I put up like five parts like I've done on other projects? And what ends up happening is you can't seem to find them on YouTube. And somebody might watch part one and then not be able to find part three. And it just so that's why I'm asking you, is it better to put up the whole thing at once in one chunk or not? Let me know on that. You know, leave the comments down here. Hit the bell so that you get this. I guess, I don't know, I've been out on YouTube for a while. So if that's what's working and how you find them on your page, then go ahead and use that. So let me just, I'll run this real quick, like, and we'll find out whether you guys want to watch the rest of this video.
Okay, so the engine itself is a 1-inch bore with a little over that in the stroke, about an inch and a half stroke. The 10-inch flywheel and an 8-inch flywheel on the far side. It is both water-cooled and air-cooled. And it has beveled gears driving a 4-to-1 on a, I don't know what that is, 80-millimeter computer fan down there. All of this is made on both my Logan, the Big Dog, and my Harbor Freight milling machine. The heat sinks were applied before I water-cooled it. And so those are actually heat sinks that I made back in like 1997 at a machine shop I was working at, you know, lunch break. And that was back when we were still trying to overclock the Pentium 3 to get to 1 gigahertz. And I was actually able to do that. I was at 1.2 before Intel ever came out with the Toolantin 1.2. And I wanted to go into the heatsink business, and I had the money saved up to buy the machine to do it. And my father did not want me to do that in the house. I don't know, maybe he was opposed to, you know, cutting oil or something. But they're aluminum, and maybe you can see the shape there. The engine is all adjustable in every way, shape, or form. The piston is adjustable in the cylinder as far as how close to the head it gets. The camshaft is adjustable as far as location on the crank and its timing. The timing of the valve is adjustable, and its throw of the valve is adjustable. The spring pressure is adjustable. All of it is adjustable. So I can adjust it a lighter spring pressure right there, a lighter spring pressure for slower running, and a heavier spring pressure for faster running. Of course, it runs faster without the bevel gears spinning for certain, and it's a ton quieter. I started out with a alcohol burner, and I tried all kinds of fuels, you know, like a wick burner with alcohol and naphtha and denatured alcohol, and every other fuel you could try, and they all make a mess on, in, and around the engine. And I decided that it's just a bunch better if I made this here propane burner. And so, you guys, I got another video about propane burners in the below for steam engine there. And there you go. So, real quick run, like.
Try to have coffee and do this at the same time. So, yeah, turn the gas on. There's oil points everywhere. This is my oiler. It's a drip oiler. I made out of a whole fuel filter. Goes directly into the cylinder. Right here, the valve. This whole arrangement is of my doing. Yeah, there is nobody else on the internet that has this valve arrangement, as far as I can tell. Everybody uses some sort of flap or up and down horizontal, and this here actually moves at a radius. I'm the only guy with that. So, yeah, let's give this a spin. Yeah, let me come around and give it a spin. That is a one of those peg cans. And it does fill up with water, and on that gas bottle would last me many days. I haven't figured out how long it takes because it hasn't never run out on me where consistently, so I can tell you how long. It would take hours and hours and hours to heat that can up, even on a hot day. There's no water in it right now because I just don't need it. When I first started, I was using a propane bottle, right, like this one here, to be the coolant tank. And after a couple of hours, I probably could have boiled a hot dog in there, which I was going to use at the town fair, which is one of the reasons why I made this engine, because my old lady, her girlfriend, won a prize over at the Deerfield Fair here in New Hampshire for her dried flour arrangement. And I said, you know what? I'm going to build one of them engines and put it in there.
Oh, there ain't no category for that. You won't win a prize for that.
Okay, ain't nobody else got one, but yeah. So here's the gig. If you guys want to see the whole build video on this engine in one chunk or in several chunks, let me know. The oil of the air drips into that top of tubing, which goes down into the cylinder. One drip per, depends on how fast this runs. Like I say, I believe the gear that comes off of one of those old handbrake drills, and I had to straighten that gear in every way, shape, or form, because they never planned on it running like that. It is an antique gear. I definitely had to turn both the bore and the gear piece so they were straight on both sides. I made the attachment point, made the shafting, everything that goes on there. Everything is handmade, all of it. I say handmade, but 95% of it is milled. So, thanks for watching, you guys.